And now I welcome you to join us for a review of The Cupid Crisis, the fourth Holiday Hijinks game.
Like all the Holiday Hijinks games, this small box 18-card escape room was designed by Jonathan Schaefer. It's published by Grand Gamers Guild, who we welcome this year as a Tabletop Bellhop sponsor.
The Cupid Crisis is a 60-minute mystery for one or more sleuths of any age. It has the highest difficulty of the Holiday Hijinks games, with a rating of 3 out of 3.
Now, each Holiday Hijinks game is a standalone game, and despite being the fourth game in the series, it's not the fourth we played or reviewed. Check out our previous reviews of The Kringle Caper, The Independence Incident, The Birthday Burglary, and The Turkey Trial.
All of these games have a few things in common. They're all low-priced, small card packs that contain only 18 cards that work with a browser-based, device-independent web app, and each is themed on a different North American holiday.
So the Cupid Crisis is, of course, based on Valentine's Day and has you arriving at a restaurant to meet your date when things go horribly wrong. While the story is written from a single-player perspective, you could play this game with any number of players. The puzzles in the Cupid Crisis are very modular, and you are presented with more than one to work on at once, which is perfect for splitting up the work between two or more players.
Due to the escape room nature of this game, we didn't do an unboxing video as we don't want to spoil any of the puzzles. We can assure you, though, that the component quality here is great. The card designs are clear and functional, and the puzzles come in a variety of types. Many of the puzzles here expect you to write on the cards. While you can do that, we suggest you use some penny sleeves and wet erase markers or tracing paper. That way you can pass the resealable pack onto another group when you're done.
Yeah, in this particular case, the copy we were playing had obviously been played before, which is pretty cool. Now, to play the Cupid Crisis, you open up the card pack and follow the instructions inside, which are basically going to have you put the deck of cards aside without looking at them and open up the web app on your phone, PC, laptop, TV, whatever. There, you're going to select the proper game because they're all listed at once and hit play. The app will then give you a brief introduction and have you flip over the first card.
This card presents you with a puzzle, with the first puzzle, in an odd twist for the series, an answer for that puzzle. Sort of. The answer is entered into the app, which then continues the story and has you draw a bunch more cards. For each magnifying glass you find on these cards, you'll have to answer an answer in the app, leading you to draw more cards until you get to the end.
Now, if you get stuck, the web app includes some standard puzzle-based information, things like the NATO alphabet and flag codes, and specific to this particular game, famous love stories. There's also a graduated hint system that gives you hints on one step at a time, leading up to the final solution to each puzzle if you get really stuck. Now, we ended up using more hints in this game than any of the others we played.
Eventually, you'll get to the final puzzle, enter the answer, and are given a score out of 5, and the option to send your play info to Grand Gamers Guild so they can use it to help balance and rate future games in the series.
Now, this was the fifth Holiday Hijinks game we played, and the first that Deanna and I tried on our own. With the Valentine's Day theme, we thought it'd be appropriate to try this one with just the two of us, without the kids this time.
Not that you can't share a holiday about relationships with your kids, but it makes for a nice break as well for a family that normally games together and maybe doesn't always get the time to just let the grown-ups play games together.
Plus, the story here is very Valentine's date night story and not one of handing out cute paper messages to your friends. Now, the Cupid Crisis worked pretty well, two players. And that's what I was hoping for from this one. Right from the start, you're presented with multiple different puzzles to work on, and each of these leads to a new puzzle and a sort of branching path. Each individual puzzle can be solved by one person, but it's nice to have someone else there to help. Some puzzles we were able to solve on our own, while others we swapped back and forth, and a couple took both of us puzzling through it together, which just felt about right.
As with any puzzle game, having someone who can view things differently from you is often all it takes to crack something you've been spinning your wheels over.
And actually, in the end, due to the way we split up the tax, there were actually some puzzles I never even saw, and some Deanna didn't see. We solved them on our own, entered our answers in the app, drew the next cards, and went on to the next puzzle.
Perhaps a bit less date night sharing than some might want, but a totally valid way to work through the solution.
And it's actually the first one I'm like, I could play this again, because I could try the other puzzles. Now, the Cupid Crisis does have the highest rated difficulty of all the Holiday Hijinks games we played, and I can see why. We used more hints here than we ever have before and got totally and completely stuck on the final puzzle. Now, early in the game, there was one puzzle that we needed two hints for. one, the first hint's always like, you need these cards, right? So we had that. That was fine. But the second one actually gave us a clue what to do with those cards, and we didn't end up using that. Now, I'm sure one of us may have figured this out at some point, but our play time would have been much longer and our score probably much lower. The final puzzle, though, we had to use three steps of hints before figuring out what the game wanted us to do. We probably spent 20 or 25 minutes of our 1 hour playtime just on that one puzzle.
And that's a big jump from previous puzzles. Have you even used more than one hint on any puzzle before?
I think all we've ever used was the make sure you need, like, here's the three cards that are relevant right now, or, you know, you have to use all the cards. We've never gone on to find out what we had to do with the cards before. This is the first time. And we had to do that basically for two puzzles. Right. Now, overall, though, the puzzles we did solve on our own and together did give us that whole, you know, makes you feel smart thing, which is what you want from one of these kind of games. And I would say the overall experience was very solid. While there were a few times I think we could have used more players, maybe we wouldn't have gotten stuck with another set of eyes, I do think this ended up being a solid date night game for us.
And that's certainly a great way to play it, though I don't think there would be anything wrong with sharing it with the whole family either.
What'll be interesting now is maybe I'll let the kids play through it on their own and see how they do, which is something we haven't gotten to done with the previous copies because we've all played together. Now, of all the Holiday Hijinks games we played, the Cupid Crisis felt the most like the two of us were actually trapped in an actual escape room, wandering around, trying various puzzles and looking at each other for help when needed, and then eventually even calling on the staff for a hint when stuck.
Escape room in a deck, you might say.
There you go. Mark's going to start putting that on all the packaging now. Now, if you're looking for a fun way to spend an hour or so with your significant other or your family on or around Valentine's Day, the Cupid Crisis is a good choice. While we played this one at home, I could also see playing this out at a coffee shop, winery, craft brewery, perhaps even at a restaurant. But if you do that and decide to play out, make sure you pack some paper to take notes and some card sleeves and markers so you don't have to write on the cards.
There you have our thoughts on the Cupid Crisis, the fifth game in the Holiday Hijinks series of games from our show sponsor, Grand Gamers Guild. We're going to be back next week with the final game currently released in the series, The Groundhog Gambit, so be sure to watch for that.
Now, what I love most about these games is how much punch they pack for being only 18 different cards and how different each game in the series feels. Now, you can pick up a copy of The Cupid Crisis as a standalone game, as a print and play, or part of a bundle at GrandGamersGuild.com.
Use our exclusive discount code Bellhop, B-E-L-L-H-O-P, to save 10% off your order.
Now, is there a series of games that keeps impressing you the more content that's released for it? Something that every time you try out a new one, you're like, damn, they got to be out of ideas by now. How do they keep coming out with these games? I would love to hear about that game in the comments.
Or better yet, jump on the Tabletop Bellhop Discord and share your thoughts there. If you aren't a member yet, you can find it at discord.tabletopbellhop.com.